Good morning, world, and hi, everybody. I just woke up, and this is my current hair as of the moment. It usually gets worse than this, but I'm trying to be more authentic on my vlogs, my upcoming vlogs. Today, I was realizing that it's been almost a year since I left the Philippines last February 14th. Wherein I was flying in the middle of the pandemic and countries imposing lockdowns, so I didn't left. And here I am, trying to fulfill my American dreams, which I still have no clear idea what is an American dream or am I even already living my American dream? Anyway, I don't know where to lead this daily vlog today, but I guess today I'll be just sharing my journey for my whole entire process, me getting here in America and staying here in America, especially being Filipino. Nahihirapan ako kung mag-vlog pa ako ng Tagalog or mag-vlog pa ako ng English or siguro magta-Taglish na lang ako in the middle para mas comprehensible for my audience. Okay, all right.
Shower. I just came from the gym. It's been almost a year that I left the Philippines, and I'm turning 1 year here in America. My goodness, napaparami na ilagay ko na ano. And my hair, my face is growing. Okay, it's almost been a year since I left the Philippines. By next month, by the time that I'll be posting this, Feb 14 to be exact, when I left the Philippines. And the whole shenanigans of how I even got here was very funny in many ways. At least the way I want to narrate it in my head. At first, I really just wanted to stay here for 3 months and come back again after some time, because I was actually planning to go to Belgium for Tomorrowland. But unfortunately, the pandemic thing happened, and so I wasn't able to attend the music festival because it was shut down. So as far as I'm concerned, I don't think music festivals will open anytime soon, especially that the coronavirus is mutating and we're discovering a lot of variants. And now we're also knowing from the news how easily those new variants can be transmittable to anybody. When I first came here in America, I thought I was already going to adapt easily to the cultures here, but I was wrong. Despite being exposed to so many like pop culture or what I read online, what I see from the internet or on social media, it still is different when you're a part of that culture and you get to see a bigger picture of what it's really like to live here in America. And mind you guys, when I first came here, my savings wasn't really the best fit out of all, so I just wanted to say thank you for the friends who helped me along the way to help me establish, especially my stay here, and I very much appreciate every single thing that you guys did for me. And also shout out to my boyfriend, because as of now he's my biggest supporter in life. When I came here, I really didn't have a clear picture of how am I going to break in through this country here, or especially the industry that I wanted to be in. Like, I wanted to learn how to act and also try to penetrate Hollywood. And by the way, it's not easy living here in America. Number one, you have to account the cost of living here is not very cheap, especially if you're planning to live and stay in California. Well, lucky me, my friends who were helping me at that time, they were staying in Las Vegas. So somehow, cost of living in Vegas is not as expensive as it is in California or in the cities like New York. So somehow, I kind of got by. And I kind of like Vegas actually, because it's not a boring place like some of the states here in America. And what else? Culture shock. I think that was one of the things that I thought that, like, again, what I said and mentioned earlier in my statement, it was something that I thought that I was going to get used to, but being here really opened my eyes to kind of what is really going on in the power player of the world, which is one is America, and how it really shapes a lot of things that we are currently utilizing as at the moment, like social media, and how the way of life here is totally different from where I came from, like the Middle East and the Philippines. I was culture shocked at some degree because people here are more expressive about almost anything from political opinions or to their daily life activities or events. And my Asian culture in somehow is quite the opposite. People like to make small talks here, and I like small talks at a certain degree. But I keep telling this to my boyfriend that there are times where I just don't want to be with anybody in the elevator for me to avoid small talks with any other people. But don't get me wrong, I'm still very approachable. I still do talk to people if they talk to me. But there are days where I just don't feel like interacting with anybody. I'm currently, as of the moment, by myself because my boyfriend is out of town. And OMG, I'm getting confused what to do next. I don't really have anything much to do today. Probably I'll just edit and put some content for my boyfriend's Instagram or his business and for my startup business, by the way. I'll be tagging my business in the screen here. And please don't forget to support my business. It's a small business. It's something that has to do with sustainability and recycled materials like plastic from the ocean. So please check it out, guys. I noticed in America that a lot of people here don't really mind talking about like money. How much are you making? How much are you putting in to the bank? Kind of like that. And it's still something that I don't know if it's a universal rule, but it's something I'm very uncomfortable discussing, like what you do and blah blah blah. When I was starting to grow my Instagram, and people and some of my friends were actually calling me as an influencer, I still don't want to associate myself with that word because I felt like that word was so overused and it's given so many misconnotations with a backlash attached to it. So I kind of get irked, or I shiver and cringe whenever I hear that word, or I'm being called an influencer. I don't want to call myself an influencer. I prefer to call myself as a content creator because I like sharing things. I like sharing my life, my knowledge, or all the things that I experience that I feel like is beneficial for some of you guys who are taking their time to watch my videos. So like now, I am mostly trying and vlogging about my experience here in America, my first 1 year here experience in America, and why I really decided to further move here rather than stay in the Philippines. Don't get me wrong, I love the Philippines. It's just that I feel like America has just more conveniences when it comes to first public transportation, internet system, payment, government. Although I'm not an American citizen as of the moment, I'm still in the process of getting my green card, but there was also this thing before I got fired, and the days when I was still employed for my previous company, which was Qatar Airways, I was at the last stretch of my career. I was really attempting to resign, and one of my plans was to move and establish a career here. Even though things didn't happen according to plan because of the whole pandemic thing situation, but somehow I'm really glad that I'm here in America because somehow I'm taking baby steps to be where I want to be in the future. It's not easy, that's one thing. I only have like two friends here that I'm really close with. And of course, I had to deal with the loneliness and homesickness, and also being away from my sister and my family. So So it's quite a bit of a struggle, and it was also another new environment for me that I need to get myself used to. I never denied, and I even vlogged about it, that at one point I felt so depressed that I was doubting and asking myself whether I was making the right decision, whether is it okay for me to just throw everything down the window and move back to the Philippines again. But then again, if I do that, I'll be wasting time, effort, and money, especially the effort, the amount of effort from myself and other people who helped me stay here. So that was something that I just didn't want to throw down the window and give up just like that. And I'm really glad that I did. I was having this conversation with my boyfriend, like, I wonder why and how we would communicate to each other, or how would we be together if I actually did decide to leave the country and just stay in the Philippines. But somehow, I guess love conquers all. Just kidding, char lang. Nagpapakaano lang ako. And so here I am. Alam niyo guys, I really came to a point where I was seeing my bank account starting to dry up, and then I got really so worried that I don't know what to do. Parang at that point, I'm still not allowed to work because I still don't have my papers. I'm still waiting for the papers, and somehow because of the whole pandemic thing, everything has to be delayed. So legal-wise, I really am not allowed to do anything that will generate me income, and it's really tough. And plus, at that time, sabi ko, shucks, yung visa ko na tapos na. But somehow, I managed to extend my stay here. So it's tough. It's really tough. There are a lot of things that I had to constantly remind myself the purpose, why I even moved here from the first place, and why am I here to begin with. There were many things that were going through my head at that time, because I felt like sometimes I don't know to which direction my life is going. I was undergoing existential crisis, like the question, why am I always here, that question. Or no, I mean, why am I here? That was the constant question that I kept asking myself before. But I guess if I didn't try and risk, I wouldn't find out. And I'm glad I did, because I am in a place in my life right now where I feel like I'm really reaching my goals. And dito sa America, guys, kailangan hindi kayo dapat maarte. Promise. Like, when it comes to job, you gotta be willing to do everything to earn the money. Yeah, at a certain point, of course. Ayun guys, sa totoo lang, it is a tough country. This is a tough country. There's a lot of competition. I want to try acting, and I want to try to be in the social media sphere at one point, but I don't even know how am I going to do that, or how am I going to break into that very competitive industry, especially here in America, where there's just a stream of influencers, content creators that you have to compete with, and you got to really put a lot of knowledge and science behind it, because nowadays, there are many ways to break into this industry, or it's still tough. It's very tough. That's one thing I know, but I guess nothing really comes easy in life. Everything we need to do or we dream of, we really need to work hard for. And I guess this is where I am. I'm trying my best, climbing up something. Especially, I'm very passionate as of the moment right now into being an entrepreneur. I started my experience because I just wanted to experience and build my knowledge about it when I first started my candle business, which I still will pursue in the near future. It's just that now I have to halt it because I'm having some logistical problems when it comes to it. And I'm having a problem, how am I going to execute in a mass production kind of way with my candle business, but that's on halt. But my main focus right now is I'm coming up with a product which is recycled materials. It's a bag, actually, that is made of recycled materials, which is also vegan and very eco-friendly. That will be very beneficial, especially if you're someone like me who always travels and always carry a ton of stuff with them. So guys, watch out and stay tuned. I'll be posting my product probably anytime soon, and also I'll be posting it in the screen here. Check it out, okay? Anyway, guys, so I guess let me know what type of content you still want to see me posting about my stay here in America, or the type of journey that I have to undergo through, or the things that I experienced. But I guess along the way, I'm still trying to get a hang of how to vlog seamlessly and be more spontaneous and natural, that I don't stutter, that I don't have to constantly filter and also construct my sentence in my head before I say it. Because mind you guys, even though sometimes if you feel like I'm already spontaneous enough, but I still struggle. Sometimes I would rewatch my footage and judge myself. Like, what the fuck am I saying? What the hell am I saying? Okay, so that's it, guys. So if there's any suggestion or any type of content that you'd like me to do, my experience or share my experiences here in America, or share an experience with you guys by filming it, let me know in the comment section down below. And I hope you did learn a thing or two from this video. And please be safe, always wear your mask. And thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, and goodbye.